Oh man, we up, we live, man, and of course, there is some shenanigans of the day. Lord have mercy. So I go and I turn on. Let's wait for the Facebook family to get in. You know the text messages should be coming out soon. There they go. Now I want to see if the text messages is live as I think it's going to be. All right, let me go and reconnect. Now, you pay all this money for all this cable and shit up in the house, and all of a sudden, I can't get a signal when I want to do a show. I don't understand it, but hey, I'm not mad. At least my kids got the internet, right? Kids like the internet. My kids got the internet. So we've been blessed enough to do that. Let me see. Uh-oh, yeah, it's moving. So let me know if you are able to get the moving text, because the text has just went out. So that means we can officially start the show. Family, I want to say great Kaumba to you. I am looking forward to tomorrow, because tomorrow, 11:30, we have the Per Onk. We will be having a group discussion. I will be one of the speakers. Brother Renee will be one of the speakers. And maybe we might be joined by somebody else. But the point is, you see the flyer. I want the family to come out. All right, come out, support. Let's have a discussion. Let's build something that let's build something that's eternal. All right. So Brother Shaka's up. Brother Christine is up. Speaking of Brother Shaka, I'm going to open the lines. I'm gonna pour these libations real quick. I'm gonna open the lines. I want to send shouts out to my brother Quabinah Anton Nixon. I think they still in Akron right now for some type of conference. But I I'm so out the loop now. I don't know what's going on. So I'm gonna open up them lines after we do these libations so that we go and get this. We can rapportate and talk about some of the stuff that we need to talk about. But today is the day of Kaumba. But, and with that, let me tell you what happened, family. Now, first off, you know, my whole playlist on Spreaker, after 3 years of building this damn playlist, is just gone. I don't know where it went. Didn't leave me a note. Didn't tell me it was leaving me. My whole goddamn playlist, except for two songs, is gone. So now I gotta go and dig back through the crates and build it up. But I don't even know if I wanna build it up anymore, because I am becoming so frustrated with the sound crackling and stuff. But I gotta build this whole library. But you know, what that's telling me is that, you know, because that means that a lot of those tunes that I'm gonna rebuild it on is gonna be Shaka tunes anyway. People that I know tunes, you know what I'm saying? I love other artists. But I only want to promote those that, you know, I want to promote family. Shouts out to Sister Amatu. Thank you for joining us. Holding up the Spreaker fam. All right, here we go. Let's see. But y'all know what it is. This is Giami Journey Media. And hold on, let me massage my, Amatu is in, New Jersey. Let me go on and, I had to massage. Here we go. This is Giami Journey Media. Lord have mercy. Will you not stop testing me? Let's try it again. I heard she wanted a recipe. She left. She left the recipe on the Spreaker station from the show yesterday. You know what I'm saying? So, but here we go. Listen.
That's too sour.
This is Giami Journey Media. That's a little bit better. This is the Heart of a Simba production. deadly toast, right? Go ahead.
When we strike, the world will all paradise.
All right, we got Shaka already waiting online. You know what I'm saying? Even though I said I wasn't going to open up the lines yet, we got Shaka. I'm going to open up just because it's Shaka. I think that's Shaka. Shaka, that number don't look familiar, man. All right, but I'm going to open up the lines because I sent it out, so I'm going to open it up. Who said they wanted the heart juice or had a daughter with? I don't know. I remember that, but I don't remember who it was. Maybe it was Alma 2. You know what I'm saying? But hey. All right.
Joining conference now.
All right, so.
This call is being recorded.
Oh, so now they're going to hang up. They're going to get shy, and they're going to hang up on Brother High Tim. Right? But hey, family, so here we go. Let's go on and do what we supposed to do the way we can only do on Giamme. Alma 2 said it was her, Brother Shaka. So, the only way we could do it, right, will we strive to blow up your old paradigms. Grab your glass. Grab your water. I think Shaka's up on the line. Forget the sound, but drink your water. I got my backup singers. Come on, drink your water. Lift your glass and drink your water. Lift your glass and drink your water. Lift your glass and drink your water. Lift your glass. Drink, 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 drink. Take your breath and drink your water.
No.
Take your breath and drink your water.
No.
Take your breath and drink your water.
No.
Take your breath.
No.
Drink,
no.
Drink,
no.
Drink.
No. No, 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 no.
Drink, 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 drink. Drink some water.
No.
Move your body, drink some water.
No.
Move your body, drink some water.
No, no, no.
Move your body.
No.
Drink,
no.
Drink,
no.
Drink,
no.
Drink.
No. No, no.
Drink, 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 drink. Now raise your glass and toast your ancestors.
No.
Raise your glass and toast your ancestors.
No.
Now raise your glass and toast your ancestors.
No. I need to drink something.
Now raise your glass.
I need to drink some.
Drink,
no.
Drink,
no.
Drink,
no.
Drink.
No.
Drink.
No, 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 no.
Drink, 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 drink. Take your breath and drink your water.
No.
Lift your glass and drink your water.
No.
Move your body, drink some water.
No.
No. No. Drink, 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 drink.
No, 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 no.
Drink, 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 drink. Enough of that, enough of that. Let's get the conversation popping. All right, so we got another guest up on the line. We got Brother Shaka on the line, of course. Representing the mind of Shaka, one of those extended family members. You know what I'm saying? That we always, he's the co-host of most of my shows because he always represents, right? So then we also have a caller from Columbus that's on the line. I don't know who that is. Who else is on?
CeeLo.
Miss CeeLo is on. What? Miss what?
CeeLo. Wait. CeeLo is in Facebook jail. So anything that I type, it won't appear. I was typing the other night. But I'm on Facebook lockdown for like 3 days. I got kicked off because I posted something like...
What you post? Because I know you posted it up on GME Journey then. Oh my God.
No, I didn't.
You should have.
It was actually in, it was in another group. It was a picture of, number 45 with his hand up a woman's dress and it said, I respect women.
Oh man.
I'm on Facebook.
Hey, but hey, what? That's how it goes, man. But are you still able to see the show through Facebook, though, right?
I can see it, but when I was typing to you the other day, I got kicked off the same day you made me an administrator on GME Journey. So you notice that's when everything stopped. So I can't like anything. I can't post anything. I can't, even if I type, like, hi in your feed, like right now, you wouldn't see it. The other day, you didn't see what I was typing to you.
Man. Hey, man, I'm going to tell you what.
But how did you find out? I mean, did they send you a notice?
Oh, it tells you right there.
Oh, okay.
It tips you off, you have to log back in, and then it tells you what you did, and we're removing this post, and how many days you're going to be locked down. I got kicked off 5 days before. This time, it's only 3.
Damn. Wow. See, this is why, family, this is why we got to hold on to our information, right? So when I'm sending out texts, I need y'all to understand, family. I'm not playing.
Oh, I can get some texts.
Oh, yeah, because the text is... Exactly.
That's why I know you're here, but I just can't respond to anything.
I
just called me Mr. Christine. Hello. You said Brother Christine. It's sister. Hello,
Cito.
Hello.
Who
said? Call me brother.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah, at the very, very beginning. Yep, at the very, very beginning, you said we got Brother Stocky and Brother Christine.
Oh, I apologize. You gotta check a brother. Hey. But go ahead, Brother Shaka. You had something you wanted to say.
Yeah, that's not an isolated incident. You know, I just had somebody recently tell me that they couldn't friend me. That's bananas.
Well, not only
can... Well, you can get too many friends. They limit the number of friends you can have. So if you have over a certain amount, they make you wait till some of your friends filter down, and then you can get be friends with people. There's a friend of mine from Youngstown. He had over the friend limit, and they wouldn't let him add any friends. Eventually, they sent me a notice and said, okay, you can friend them now.
That was so nice of them white peoples. They allow us to friend each other.
Do you have over 1,000 friends, Shaka?
Yeah, I got 2,500.
Yeah, the limit is 1,000, first limit, and then I think they can push you up. But, yeah, you keep hitting those touch points. Of limits, and now I guess eventually
it's family,
we can have more, but that's what it is. It's not that
you have, I'm gonna have to go through and throw some of the dead weight over, man. I don't know, throw some of the dead things off. They just hanging around filing anyway. Kick them out.
Mm.
Yeah, you know, I already noticed. I gotta put a project out so people can, so I know who my real supporters are.
Hey, that's what the super phone for, man. Trying to let you know.
Yeah.
But I understand. But you might have to use mine then, right?
Yep.
Mm.
How's that working out?
Well, you've been getting your text.
Yep.
Mm.
Yep.
Then you've been getting the images.
Yep.
You know when something going down in Columbus?
For the most part.
Okay. I mean, I think I got you on the Kwanzaa list, too. So, anything that we're doing here, and people let me know, I'm blasting it out. So, it's working. And I know response rates, like, if I send out links, it'll let me know how many times the links got pushed. You know what I'm saying? It'll let me know. I mean, if I was the link with Shopify, it would tell me who was buying what. But I don't do Shopify. I'm on Gumroad. So, I use Gumroad.
Oh, okay.
But it's all cool. But hey, family, we're gonna do this toast. We're going to do this toast. And it's kind of disheartening that, you know, that they could put you on punishment. That's basically what they could put you on punishment. This is why.
Yep.
This is why.
Sent me to my room.
Okay, we was joined by Miss Keisha. I think she's in New Jersey too. Is Miss Amatu's daughter-in-law. Welcome to the family. Her name is Keisha, making power moves. I can't see the rest of the name, so they only give me a little corner on Spreaker, but I want to welcome you to the Spreaker fam. We also live on Facebook at Giami Journey if you want to interact. We also had a call-in line. The call-in number is
614-556-4535.
Thank you, 4535. Those is my daughter, 614-556-4535.
And we're also his
brother. And I tell him, let me add, man, if anyone wants to get in touch with me in particular about the, about the Heart Health June product, they can shoot an email to me at themindofshaka@gmail. So it's the mind of SHAKKA at Gmail. So,
brother, let me make sure they can hear. Brother Shaka is saying that if anybody want to get in touch with him about the Red June, about the Heart Health Ambrosia, you can reach him at themindofshaka@gmail.com. Am I saying that right?
Yeah, themindofshaka2k@gmail.
Shaka has two K's in it, @gmail.com. All right, so family, it's time for us to salute the stars of the show. Before we get into that, let's talk about the energies of the day. Today is Kaumu for those that speak the language. Like I said, because the first part of building the tribe, the first part of building the nation, the first part of building is the language. It's the language, right? So, we call the days of the week by them and the Ngunza Saba. So right now, we are on Kaumba, which is creativity. The modic principle of the day is order. The color is orange. We are, the hermetic law is cause and effect. If you was born on this day, your male, if you was a male born on this day, your name is Kwame. If you were born on this day, you're a female, your name is Ama. God is shocking. She said, Amatu says she got it. She will email you. So we got creativity, order, orange, cause and effect, male, Kwame. This is Kwame's day, and female Ama. That's my wife's day. She was born on Ama. All right, so she's Ama. All right, here we go. African-centered cultural virtue and value system. Now, on May 19th, we will be doing the Malcolm X Festival. May 19th, right? I want y'all to be ready for this. Now, on May 19th, we are going to start the Emotional Emancipation Circle. At least there will be an Emotional Emancipation Circle started, and we will be having the presenter up at the school, so you will be able to participate in the Emotional Emancipation Circle, right? Those of you that's in Columbus, and you will get information about further classes after that. But that's going to be one of the events that's going down on May 19th at the Malcolm X Festival at 3500 Refugee Road, Columbus, Ohio, 43232. I hope I gave you enough information that you can find it. Right? The big building, way in the back. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have vendors. We're going to have live music. We're going to have the hottest DJs. We're going to have a talent show with the young people. We're going to have an art exhibit featuring Malcolm X. We're going to have a photographer there going around getting snaps of people. Of course, you're going to have your permission. But come draped out in your cultural best. You know what I'm saying? I mean, don't get all hot and sweaty because it's going to be hot that day, right? We don't want you. But, you know, if you got your little, like my little Giami symbol, you know what I'm saying? I might wear my Giami symbol and a nice little shirt, and I might want, you know, want to be in the picks next year because this is an annual event. and we and it's jumping off, family. And the support is crazy, right? The support is coming in, it's crazy, and along with the craziness of other stuff. But hey, that's neither here nor there. All right, so here we go. Here we go. Let's see. So, family, let's go on. Go ahead. Somebody got something to say? Huh?
To help the African terrorists.
Say again.
Always presents the African Heritage.
What's that?
Chairman of the Department
of Hypertension. Pardon?
Constance Brown Riggs, Health and Wellbeing.
CeeLo.
Is it here?
You're probably familiar with a lot of her work.
What's that?
What's going on?
Oh, never mind.
Let
me mute my phone.
I didn't see you. I'm like, oh my God. We've been invaded. So now, family, it's time for us to get.
Multitasking.
Hey, that's what I do too.
Sorry.
I'll be. All right, so now, I'm about to go and drink some of this ambrosia. This one ain't going to say it. I don't know. I think I got a messed up top on this one. But anyway, I'm going to go on in. But I know some of y'all like I know some of y'all like the sound effects, so let me go and help you out. Man, that was a big old SCOBY that fell out. So I won't that's my brunch. But I know y'all like to see it, so here we go. Here we go. Let's see. Just a little bit. Oh, you know why that one went like that? Somebody been breaking into my ambrosia stash. And I tighten it up. Anybody wanna confess? Oh, okay, gonna remain silent. He had the right to remain silent. Here you go.
Hey, man, let me tell you.
There we go. But go ahead.
About a half hour before you went on, I went on and just, you know, did what I did before.
I like the little effects that you had with the with your drink, man. You got the light behind it. You had a cool music, man. I'm like, what the hell? What is going on here?
Yeah. Water. Yeah. Hey, and you know what? What's crazy is before I came on to the show, I saw I had 70 views already. 70 views. And I don't know who is watching.
See, and first off, you don't know who is watching and you don't know who they're stopping from watching. Because one of the things that I'm learning about Facebook is I done had several people let me know that when they was trying to get on Facebook, they couldn't get on with us, family. I'm just saying. So we got that, like, this is why we have to start gathering our own data so that we could get in touch with people and let them know when we going on. You know what I'm saying? Like that,
yeah.
We got to start building that database of people that's interested. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said, for the Daily Toast, and this is what's amazing to me, man. On the Daily Toast, at 5:15 in the morning, we be getting 7 to 8 people at this point in time. Now, you know, we started with none, then one and two, and then it fluctuated off and on, then it's 3, then it's 4. So now it's up to 7 people listening on a daily basis, and then some people come on every other day. Or, I mean, it's like sometimes it's like people be we work together, so it's crazy. But we be having other people trying to get on, and they will not let them get on. And then when you look on, if those people that are on the Giami page, if you look and look at some of them, if you look as an editor on the Giami page, those that's on the Giami page, you'll see that it's certain things that they will not allow to happen unless you pay. So your show got 30 views, but we could push it up to 1,500 views if you allow us to, if you pay for this promotion. I'm like, what? I ain't praying. You know what I'm saying? We're going to build our audience organically. Somebody else has joined us on the line, Max. Who's calling? I think I know who it is.
Good morning.
What's come on now. Come on. You got to fill us in. You got to fill us in. You got to fill us in.
Hi.
How you doing? How's
I'm doing good.
I'm doing good. How's it tasting?
Well, you know, after we talked yesterday, I left a
them at a time. Actually, in Cleveland, if that shop guy hears voice. But,
this is a new drink.
So I moved the... This is a new drink.
Scoby. Scoby.
Scoby.
You haven't named your Scoby yet?
I got that.
Huh?
You haven't named your Scoby yet?
Kinda. I think the hot turn would give me the name.
Amatu also has to, once she starts brewing hers, she has to let us know. Fairly, I'm letting everybody know. Listen, this is an art. This is. Miss Tracy asked a question. This is an art that we're trying to share, right? I mean, it's joyous. It's an art, and we all could be brewing. And so now, what happens, Brother Hotel? What happens when we all start brewing? Then we can start in having friendly competitions about what we brewing, right? We get somebody might come up with something else or come up with another method. This is called experimentation. This is how things grow. Miss Tracy asked, "What was that thing that I text out?" That is, I think they call it the Divine Triangle. I can't remember. I have to look it up for you, Sister Tracy. But I mean, just look at the words is on there. But that's it's a little Divine Triangle, based on oh man, I wish Kwame was here. Based on the natural. I'm sorry. I can't think of what the name of it is right now, Miss Tracy. I apologize. But it got something to do with the, it's a divine number, and the pattern of the number goes, Ms. Yvette Carter is on here? The numbers go one, and then it will go to one again, and then you will add the one, and the one, it'll be two, and then you add the number.
No, you're talking about the Fibonacci sequence.
Fibonacci sequence. That is based on the Fibonacci sequence. So, you can look up Fibonacci, Miss Tracy, and it'll give you a little bit more information about the picture that I sent out on the text. If you didn't get the text, because I'm able to send out little pictures and stuff. So, one of my daughters is up on the thing, you know, hey. So, it's going to be a blessed day. So, here we go. Well, actually, I got three daughters in the room right now. Wow. So, I got two of them here. Got one of them right there. It's my grandbaby with you, Yvette. All right, so here we go, fam. We about to pour this toast for the stars of the show. You know what I'm saying? We got, unless, wait a minute, hold on. Miss Tiandra, you got any announcements? She just listening.
No, sir.
Okay. Miss CeeLo, you got any announcements? She's still multitasking. Brother Shaka, you got an announcement? Huh? I said, you got any announcements?
What did you say, Cilo?
I said, no.
Oh, any announcements? No.
Yes, okay. Brother Shaka, you got any announcements?
I do want to talk to you a little bit later, though. I have an idea about something I want to talk to you about, so I don't want to say anything about it until we figure out if it's something we can work in.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I'll talk to you later.
Yes, ma'am. Brother Shaka, go ahead. You got something?
No, go ahead, man. Let's get into the ancestors.
All right, cool. I just want to announce me, Brother Renee, and I'm not going, you know what I'm saying? We may have a third party there, and we're not sure, right? We're going we're going to send energy out, right, are going to be on a panel, and there's going to be a discussion, family, right? So, hey, we want y'all to come out and support. All right, so, but now, first, giving honor to the Creator by whatever name you choose, call that Creator. We lift up our glass, and we say, Ashe. From there, we move to the stars of the show. The reason we all gather here, we call on our personal ancestors. And once again, as I always announce, family, I have a list of ancestors, right? And the list is constantly growing because you see me going into my book. But when you start building your list, or if you get this list, you have to, I leave it in a format where you can adjust it. And it's important that when you are pouring libations, family, you start with your people. You understand what I'm saying? You start with your family. You understand what I'm saying? So now, so every day you hear me start with my family, but when you pour in your libations, family, you start with your people, all right? So here we go. We lift up our glass. Miles Brown, Ms. Ann, Robert, and Texana Davis, Herman Brown, Sr., Rosalie Tilly, Georgia William Walter, Christopher Fanny Gass, and Aunt Nina, Uncle Chris, Aunt Fiend, Cleveland and Geneva Brown, Margaret Ellis, Wash Ellis, Cecil Ellis, Alvira Brown, Gina Gaines, Herman Brown II, Barbara Twiggs, Wash Ellis, Judy, Katie Ellis, Nikki Ellis, Jamon Jones, Jeremiah Tappan, John Falara, Montague Pimentel, Nomo X, Pat Maya Ra, Malika Fakur, Dr. Marianne Williams, Kojo Kamau, Elder Farmer, Elder Millie Dixon, Tony Clark, Pastor Yusuf Weston, Elder Ajani, Elder Ron Coleman, Elder Robert Donaldson, Alfred Brofro, Hector Jr., Jay Edwards, Carlisle Harris, Grace Lundy, Inez Harris, William Bill Marks, Phyllis Rose, Sterling and Lucy Wright, Derrick L. Pullian, Deluxe Brother, Miss Edith Brooks Crawley, Miss Marie Nelson, Mr. Frederick Crawley Sr., Miss Jerry Brunson, Mr. Alonzo Johnson, Miss Marie McDowell, Janice Foster, Charles Jordan, Carol Smith, Walter Smith, Richard Triggs, Francis Johnson, Mary Franklin, Jimmy Williams, Daniel Ford, George Gibson, Nana Loretta Clark, Inez McCray, Fritz Clark, Frankie Justice, Katie Justice, Derek Randleman, Virginia Rogers, Reverend James Smith, Dolores Henderson, Calvin Spratling, Mary Elizabeth Walker, Raymond Walker Sr., Sarah Jane Carter, Michael Ford Jr., Carolyn D. Russell, Susan B. Smith, Teresa Clay, Melvin Dale Hodge, Melvin Dale Hodge Jr., Herman Copeland, Mildred Copeland, Jenny Clay, Bird Beattie, Sarah Ware, LaVita Farmer, Agosa Sue, Cheryl Harvey, Aunt Charmaine, Aunt Evelyn, Theodis Hasbury, Harvey Hasbury Sr., Leonard Dickinson, T.C. Islam, Terrell Dunbar, Will Thomas, Sarah Berry, Mark Walsh, Merle B. Thornton, Pearl G. Thornton, Ida Johnson, Ida Johnson, Florence M. Carter, Joanne Thornton, Erica, Trisha Lewis, Juanita Wright, Robert Wright, George Wright, Mary Eliza Frederick Davis, Mary Elizabeth Rogers, Mary Esther Keechler Reese, Linda Watson Hammonds, Jarrell Giles Watson, Spiro Slimmy, Selvin Lewis, Andrew Holmes, Pearl Moore, Percy Moore Jr., Mildred Owens, Booker T. Bowden, Charlie Hunt, Sammy Stover, Hilda Pearson, Sturgeon Thornton, Richard Thornton, Lavina Hall, Freeman Bankster, Mary Moss, Sophia Peacock, Willie Thornton, Napoleon Kennedy, Mark Ramsey, Paul Ramsey, Matt Ramsey, David Ramsey, Charles E. Thornton, Frankie Quails, Urania Thornton, Bernice Quails, Ernestine Jackson, Frankie Johnson, Teresa Mormon, Leon Johnson, Charles Bell, Vivian Ramsey, Essie Johnson, Delrita Johnson, Leon Johnson, James W. West Sr., James Parham, Dana Jones, Henry Worlds, James Farmer, Mary Chavez, Leon Grace, Bessie Johnson, Hattie Levester, Mary Moreland, Paul Moreland, Elder Caleb, Rosemary Martineer, Elder Imatet Wellman, Fred Douglas Triggs Sr., Delma Triggs, Thomas Alula Berry, Lacey and Eleanor Howe, Franklin Russell Davis, Fred Douglas Triggs II, Vina Triggs, Reverend Eddie Moore, Helen Fuller, Eugene Jackson Sr., Richard Ellis, Silas Alexander, Charles Maxwell, Percy May Alexander, Arthur Reynolds, Stanley Lockhart, Ricky Lockhart, William Lockhart, Woodrow Lockhart, Brenda Porter, Deacon Hargrove, Carla Sawyer, Andrew Parker, Doris Donald, Ellis Murphy. Now, the list continues to grow. We got DeFritis Hines, Inez Bostic, Edna Bostic, Winifred Scannelberry. We got Eugene Spratling, Calvin Spratling. We got Charles Wooden. We got Joe Davis. We got Timothy Butler. We got John Dewey, Ruth Beard. We got Miriam Johnson. We got Wilbur Longmire. We got Edith Cadney, baby. Just because you don't have to talk louder because I'm talking. Keenan Catney. It's real life here, Giamme. We got Janice Carter, Michael Carter, Leon Peanut Carter, Margaret Carter, William Carter, Lisa Jordan, Charles Lee Mosley. We got Gene Holmes, Dana Jones, Peter Charles, Christy Nichols, Cardinal Robinson, Rosemary Charles. We got Ada Pearl, Bob Ingalls, Jack Wallace, Warren P. Finch, Tim Ingalls, Audrey Finch, William Billingsley Jr. We got Jennifer Sensenbaugh. We got Hazel Gatson, Jerry Bradley, Brian Watson Jr., Kaneko Parsons. We got Stacy Trice, Frank Smith, Mother Bertha, Michael Leonard, David Brown. We got Ruth Carter, June Cox, Ruth and Paula Cox, Ronald Irving, Judy Hubbard, Irene Johnson, Francis Boots Jefferson. We got Dan Wilkinson Sr. We got Emma McClendon. We got Jerry Doyle, Amina Robinson, Patricia Williams, Shabaka Ture. We got Donna Hill and Richard Gleavis. We got Lee Irby. We got Tom Irby, Void Irby, Jim Gaucher, George and Haley Johnson, Archie and Margaret Armstead. We got Archie Beck, Anna McGill. We got Aunt Becca. We got Alice Arnold, Arthur Arnold, Hattie Reed, Charles Reed. We got Eula and Andrew Baker, Patricia and Edwin Brooks, Gwendolyn and Bob Hatch, Kimball Vernon, Bradley Kim, Janie Harriet Tubman Cates, Spencer Sturgis, Sally Mae Baker, Ethel Baker, Creola Baker, Geneva Baker, Aaron Nino Baby Hatch, Hatch Sr., Mally Miller, Housie Hatch, Dad Cleveland, Mother Gibson. We got Alex Nissen. We got John Bowie. We got Lester and Rachel Sanders. We got Doretha Ross, Riola Ross, Robert Nelson, Francis Stevenson, Leroy Stokes. We got Neely Johnson, Fletcher Swan, Maddie and Charles Scott. We got Vivian Stephenson. We got Mona Ann. We got Martha Ford Dawson, Big Mama, Nanny Harris, Eva Ford, James Heston. We got Margaret Towns, Mary Williams, Leroy Q. Heath Sr., Albert Moore, Miss Vanilla, Albert Motley, Geraldine Elizabeth, Douglas Thompson, Earlington Houston. Family, the list is growing, right? And we want to send shouts out to all those ancestors, and we lift up our glass and we say, Ashe. All right, from there, family, where we go? We move to the present moment. We salute this present moment. This is our moment. This is our time. This is our time to shine. This is our time to build. This is our time to become legends. Become legendary, right? So we lift up the glass to this moment, right? And we use all of the wisdom, all of the power, all of the prayers, all of the blessings that our ancestors left us. And we stand up on their shoulders in the now, and we scream out, Ashe. From there, we move to the future. We call on our children yet to be, our children that are here now. We lift our glass because we know that we are responsible for building for the next seven generations. And many of us, if we lived our lives like that, family, we would change the way that we see the world. We are responsible for the next seven generations. The future is not ours, it's theirs. And we have to leave them a legacy upon which they could stand. So we lift up our glass and we salute our children. Right now, we salute them in our memory, we salute them in our hearts, and we raise our glass to them and we say, Ashe. From there, we move on to all of our relations. We call on the two-legged, that's human beings. We call on the four-legged, that's all those dogs and bulls and goats and, you know. We call on all the
fiends. Don't leave out the giraffe.
Don't leave. And the giraffes, right? We call on the wing, those are the birds that are flying around, right? Then, you know, and we call on the fin, that's all the ones that swim in the waters. We also call on all five elements. Yes, I did say five elements. You got
hey, the flora
about.
And the fauna, man. Don't forget the flora and the fauna.
I ain't get a chance to make it to the flora and the okay, to the flora and the fauna. I ain't get a chance to make it to the flora and the fauna, all right? But we right. So all of our relations, family, because we got to remember, there's an interdependence on this planet. And we all depend on each other to survive, even when we fight each other. You understand what I'm saying? We all depend on each other.
What about the 6 and the 8-legged?
Well, I haven't ran into a lot of those, but if you want to throw them in there, Shaka, we'll throw in the 6 and the 8-legged.
I got to throw it in there.
Well, I mean, you're right. It is 6 and 8-legged beings. You're right. You're right. Spiders and you're right. You're right. I mean,
people ask me why I don't got roaches, because I got spiders.
Well, thank God for the spiders. All right, fam. You know what I'm saying? I won't leave nobody out. You know, because I know some of y'all sensitive. You know, Shaka get upset because I left the spiders out. Okay, so I'm going to keep it to all of our relations. And we toast and we say, Ashe and family, I'm important. And right now, I toast the most important thing in the room. That's each and every last one of you. Because... Okay, Kwame.
The centipedes
in the middle. Hey, but hey, you know, wow. Okay. All of my relations.
And all.
Go ahead.
In all actuality, you're missing the things in that lake, like the fish and the dolphins.
Well, I did say the fin. We said the fish, but I didn't say the ones without the legs, like the snakes. So you. Oh. So.
Wait.
To all my relations. Okay. But now, back to y'all. I'm toasting y'all. I know it's shy. I know y'all humble. Y'all don't want Brother Hatem to toast all of y'all beautiful people out there. That makes this show possible. Right? Brother Kwame said, toast the gummy worms too. Okay, we'll toast the gummy. But hey... Hey, everybody got they, you know, everybody related to something somewhere, you know what I'm saying? The gummy worms, hey, you know. But hey, we lift up the glass to you. To everybody that make this show possible through your energy or through your donations or through, I mean, well, actually, we exchange, so it really ain't a donation, but y'all know what I'm saying. How we do it for all those that make the show possible, right? So we lift up our glass and we say, Ashe. Wait a minute, hold on. We need to sign Ashe. Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. I wish you peace, power, and joy, family. Now we can get down to talking about the gummy worms and the centipedes and the millipedes and the 9-legged and the 8-legged and the 6-legged.
And the 24-legged.
And
man, I'm going to tell you something. I mean, you know, spiders, man. What is your relationship like with
who,
spiders?
Who, mine?
I mean, you know.
My relationship with spiders?
Yeah.
Oh man, spiders. Well, first off, I'm a storyteller, so that should tell you what my relationship with spiders are. Anansi is some of the stories that I quote. You know what I'm saying? Anansi is one of the things that hold me into folktales. You know what I'm saying? Brother Kwame said, remember the song Centipede.
You are never more than 6 feet away from a spider, no matter where you are. They live in the coldest of climates to the hottest of climates.
And in all climates, they...
Wait a second here.
Uh-oh.
Where did we get that information? Was that from Bill Nye, the Science Guy?
No, that was...
A few scientific sources, but yeah, they are absolutely everywhere. There are spiders in the Antarctic.
No, that was for...
How many spiders have you eaten in your lifetime?
Two.
They say you eat about 8 to 10 over your lifetime because they're following you when you sleep. They come out of the walls and the rafters and the...
Thank you, C-Lo, for making... Thank you for making me feel safe. We want to toast this 8-legged...
I tell you, probably ate twice as many than the rest of us.
Man... I probably have. I sleep all the time. But I'm getting my protein. Yeah, I'm getting my protein. But.
On that ecosystem.
Right. Excellent for the ecosystem. Spiders keep a lot of madness down, family. You know what I'm saying? But. Back to my spiritual relationship with spiders. Well, not just my fit, because that's part of my physical relationship. Obviously. Thanks to CeeLo, everybody know I eat a lot of spiders when I'm asleep. Right? Sometimes we got to tell the truth. Sometimes the truth hurt. And it don't taste good either. Brother Kwame said the FDA allowed for up to 4 spider legs to be found in any of your food items. Thank you.
We ain't going to talk about roast and fly parts.
Damn. Okay. So, y'all, I don't know whether this is part of the plan, but y'all about to go and work the whole, to all my relations up out of the libation piece. Is that what's going on? Y'all don't like the all my relations piece? I can remove it, family. You know, cause
I like them just fine.
Okay, I'm just, cause now.
That's part of our heritage and our culture is to live in harmony with the world around us. We're not fighting it. We're not trying to raise it. We're not trying to.
I
almost feel like
somewhere.
I feel like in some culture, the spider is my
spiritual animal. Oh, man. Spider definitely, for me, it is. I mean, like I said, spider in certain traditions is the keeper of the stories. Man. Whew. I mean, if you don't know about a Nazi family, oh my God, y'all need to go and learn about a Nazi. For us, a Nazi was transformed when he came to this side. He was transformed into Brer Rabbit. Hey! Excuse me, it's real life here. Hey! Close this door! Excuse me, it's real life here, Giami Journey. But go ahead. I mean, you know, so he when he came over here, he was transformed into Brer Rabbit or Brother Rabbit. I want to send shouts out because Brother Kwame joined us. Miss Tamika Lee joined us. Miss Heather Ann Haynes joined us. Miss Javay Carter joined us. Miss Crystal Smith Mallory joined us. And somebody is still working the board as Giami Journey. I don't know who that is. And of course, Miss Navita, the I Make Flyers Nelson, has also joined us. So we got a full crew.
That might be me, man.
Are you working the board? I don't know. It might. Well, let's see. The last statement they said was, who said they wanted to? Oh, that was you. All right. But I'm still, yo. Yeah, that's you, Shaka. All right.
Stop. Who's that?
Yo.
Wait, who is that that said yo?
That's not you, Shaka?
No.
Stop playing, man. But hey, then that means Giami is alive. Giami Journey lives on his own. So at any given time, you can receive a response from Giami Journey and not know who the hell it is. And see, that's powerful.
Maybe.
That's powerful.
Yeah.
Shaka, that's
you. You know what's so live, man? Maybe it's a time-traveling version of us. Maybe that's us last week hitting us back because we done got there.
Ooh. Hey, I mean, all right, you know.
That's my next sci-fi joint, yo.
So,
Not from next week off, but right now. That's how tight the thread is getting.
Man.
Gotta let, each one teach one. Sometimes it's just a matter of the one.
All it takes is one. You know what I'm saying? Oh, okay, so that was Navita that said, yo. So, like I said, at any given time, you can receive a response from Giami, because the piece that I want to do with Giami Journey is I want to make Giami Journey, when I say media, I want to make it a real platform where people can get answers, get news, get everything that they need. Uh-oh, we have been joined by the Black Yoda. I am going to put up my lightsaber because I don't want to have any beef with Yoda. Brother Kwame, the floor is yours, sir. Give it up for Brother Kwame. Hold on. Give it up for Brother Kwame, y'all. It is rare that the Black Yoda comes from his temple of solitude and approaches the mic. But when he does, he got something to say. What's going on, brother? And you better not be talking about no goddamn gummy worms. But go ahead.
What's up, Kwame?
What's up, dude? No,
was looking for an answer to my question, Diane.
Where's that?
Oh, well, you know, Charles, you know, we may have to take this offline, you know.
All right, man, family just hollering up. I was going to say something, but I'll save it. All right, well, check this out. Let's do this. Because my brother, see, this is family, right? You know, like, you know when somebody got to do something, right? My brother is just itching on these goddamn keys. So we're going to let Brother Shaka go on to the mic and do your thing, man. Do your thing, man. Only on Gianni Journey Media.
Just like that this Saturday morning.
I mean, you're kicking the keys. Goddamn, come on.
Man, you know what? I was, you know what? More and more each day, I'm trying to add a little bit of character without trying to steal the spotlight. I was just, you know how they tinker on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood? I kind of felt like you were sitting in the chair. You're doing everything except for, you know, combing your hair and switching your tennis shoes around. I mean, it was kind of Mr. Rogers-ish.
Go ahead and bust out with Mr. Rogers, man.
Do you know Mr. Rogers' song? Really? Do you know Mr. Rogers' song?
Man, look, my grandmother loved Mr. Rogers.
Shit, I love the beginning of Mr. Rogers. All that shit in between the beginning and the end of Mr. Rogers is hot. It's a beautiful day.
I'm with you.
Hold on,
I
gotta say this to the audience, man. Because of the war, that they were going to snatch all that funding for public broadcasting, right?
Yeah, I remember. Oh my goodness. We're talking about so here.
Yes, and so what happened is that Mr. Rogers went to Congress.
Yeah.
And
put it down.
He put it down. There was no way, hey man. And the guy had to look at him in the eye and say, "Man, are you the one doing this?" He's like, "You just earned that $2 million." You know what I mean?
For real.
Yeah. Oh wow.
He put it down so tight, it made common black sense.
Mm. When I get out of Facebook jail, I will post up that video to Gianni Journey. I actually have that video in my archive.
I can't post these things, but I'll get it on there after my sentence is up. Man, you ain't gangster. You can't just be attacking the great pumpkin and not expecting shit to happen. See, Diane, see what happens when you let that little demon up.
So, ladies and gentlemen, coming to the stage, we have an international purveyor of music by the name of Shaka Hasbury, who will perform the lyrics that he do remember from Mr. Rogers.
Oh man, I was gonna up you one, man. And I was just gonna go ahead and play what you always want me to play.
Oh. See,
so we got all these different voices on the line right now.
It don't matter. They get quiet once the music come out.
You know what I'm saying with me? See, I tell them, you know the words. Can you teach them the words to the hook?
Hold on now. Hold on, Shaka. You remember, you know the issue with this mic. When you start talking, when I start talking, it'll take the focus off of you. So do your thing, man. I'm going to be quiet. Because if everybody seen the hook, then nobody gonna hear nothing. Because all of the mics is gonna come on and all the mics gonna be cutting off. So it's gonna sound some alien like. But go ahead, man, do your thing. I understand that you don't know the Mr. Rogers song. And it's okay.
You're right.
It's okay.
You're right, because if I did that live right now, it'd be like, whose line is it anyway? It'll be a comedy.
But you got enough people in here right now that probably...
Because you know what? I think I remember Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood more than I remember Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
Well, do that one. It's the same music. Do that one.
It's murky.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day in the neighborhood. Would you be mine? Would you be mine?
All
right,
let's see.
Yeah, we can.
Hold on, I don't want to play it up here. Hey, shout out to Shannon Jackson out of Akron, getting me this for making.
Oh, you got it?
Possible.
You got it.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, family, hold on, hold on. Before you go into the song, let me say this, family. Listen, this is how powerful what we doing is, right? I'm going to let him tell his story, as long as he keep it short. But this is what, when we start trading amongst ourselves and using our skills, right, we could do some major shit. Go ahead, Shaka, tell him real quick. Make it quick, man, because I'm
going to... All right, here we go. So, you know, I've been doing this music thing for a long while.
God damn it, don't you go back to... elementary school playing keys, man. Come on, man. Bring the story up to 2018.
Man, listen here. Listen here. My original instrument is the Fender Rhodes. Anybody that don't know what the Fender Rhodes is, if you watch D'Angelo perform ever, the piano that he plays on is called a Fender Rhodes. It's a jazz organ. I had an 88 key back in the day. And when times got rough, I had to sell it.
Sell it?
And I have not felt my musicianship ever since, you know, on a level that I did with this chord, because Fender Rhodes has a soul of its own. You can actually wiggle your fingers on the keys, and it makes a tremolo sound. So it's amazing. Anyway, I haven't had one of these in a long time. Long story short, when I got into this June thing and started understanding the science, I would tell more and more people about it, and I found Fender Rhodes on OfferUp. This is by the name of Shannon Jackson. Her dad played with some popular groups and whatnot, and this belonged to him, and he gifted it to her. And you know, as she got older, like, you know, now it's time to part with it. Man, this thing is practically brand new. 73 key Fender Rhodes, and you know, I saw it online. She wanted a certain amount of money. I know I couldn't pay. She wanted like $1,700 for it, and I know it's worth it, right? Everybody want one of these things, but I found it, and so I get to politicking with her and talking about the June being a kombucha product. She's familiar with kombucha. She buys it from Giant Eagle, and I said, no. You got to understand the benefit of brewing your own stuff. Long story short, I ended up putting some money into this equation just so it seemed like a real transaction to some. But I ultimately traded a SCOBY and a gallon of my red jewel with some money for this Fender Rhodes. And now dreams are coming true on both ends. Now she has a way to be able to help her mother with her heart health and help herself with her particular issues. It's just regular issues that we deal with that this stuff actually heals. So now she's got probiotics for life, and I've got this joint right here, which feels like home.
Wait, hold on. Before you start, man, listen. My wife goes to the gym, and she just told me that at the gym, they was trying to sell her friend a packet of probiotics for $200. I said, get the fuck. Did y'all hear what I said? Right? You know, and now, this is what's crazy about those probiotics that they sell at the gym, right? They usually only have about two strains that they have mutated. That they use. So when y'all go into the store and y'all buying no probiotics, family, be careful. It's like, I ain't gonna say it ain't good for you, but what I'm saying is, it's not natural. And we have the natural probiotic. I just need y'all to understand that. We got the real thing. So, and we teaching people how to do it. It ain't just a matter of us make, cause it ain't, you know what I'm saying? It ain't never been about making money with me. That's, you know, that's why my wife cut her eyes at me right now. It ain't about making money. You know what I'm saying? Stop cutting your eyes. It's real life here, G.I. Man.
Health is the new wealth.
Health is the new wealth. Even so, you don't need a car because you can walk where you need to go. I'm just.
Just don't get hit.
Just don't get hit by one of them unhealthy drivers that passed out behind the wheel. But but go ahead, Shaka, do your thing, man.
Oh man, here we go. Let's see here. You know what? I feel like one of these joints.
Don't you change up the song, man.
All right, here we go.
All right. Can you hear Miss Amateur?
Can you hear it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, let me go back up to this one. Hold on a second. It might be too basic for you. Hold on. We got it. It's going. Here we go.
Yeah,
go like that. You and I could change the skyline. Paint the world like a can of Krylon. Be a revolutionary icon. Life without the mic, counting on you and I to change the skyline. Play the world like a can of Krylon. Be a revolutionary icon. Life without the mic, counting on and on, no, 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 spinning it down and 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 down. In these last days of turbulent times, people listening for reason and rhyme. This is the season for myself. Step away from the heathen's desire. Today we need to defy the blind, leave the blind deny. Let those make them sing, that's my calling. I'm kind of like Denzel off of Fallen. Fact is, I got a theory like Pythagoras. I shine like make them clap to this. So pay attention to the message I've sent you. I speak from experience, things that I've been through. Time is now, and the answer isn't new. Black Phoenix and Earth is the venue, and I could change the skyline. In the world like a scared skyline. Be a revolutionary icon. I kinda feel shine light without the mic on. Nowadays, when things fall apart, it's the seeds. I paint the whole world with technicolor dreams. From the black to my center, the lyrical screams, I paint the world with seedless dreams, yo. Funny as it seems, I've seen both extremes, but it's so much to life when you live your dream. It's so much to life when you live your dream. It's so much to life. My daughter Diamond is my peace of mind. Imagine living every day without sunshine. One day, she and I would find a new beginning. Ain't no victory worth winning wars with love, monuments are glory when in Rome. Be sure to live to tell your story when I'm gone. My legacy is take me higher. For water to the roots, black phoenix from the fire. I bear witness from most extremes, from darkness to light and everything between. I shine light like Goja vibing things. But it's so much to life when you live your dreams. Yeah, it's so much to life when you live your dreams. It's so much to life when you live your dreams. It's so much to life when you live your dreams. It's so much to life, so live them. You and I could change the skyline. In a world like Santa Clara. Be a revolutionary icon. A few side of life without like on and you and I could change the skyline. In a world like Santa Clara. Be a revolutionary. That was hot.
That was magnificent. That was spectacular. But, nigga, that was not the song that you promised me. First off, you don't know Mr. Rogers. Check one, right? We forgave you for that. Then you said, brother, I tell him I'm going to do your song. That song was hot. That shit was cold. Y'all might even, if y'all come to the Malcolm X Festival, y'all might even get some of that, right? But that was not the song you promised me. And you know I'm sick. Yoda over there, forgive your ass. I'll come get you. As a matter of fact, might have a sift up in there in Cleveland that you about to go on and try to pass some June on to that might have a lightsaber with her that might be able to go and extract some justice because you promised me something that you ain't delivered. Uh-oh.
Oh, what you got? Ooh, you got playback now?
I don't know who that is. That's not me, man. No,
that was me. I was checking something out.
All right, we're going to save it for another show, but that was hot, Chaka. That was hot. We could change the skyline and, you know, the timeline and the bylines and the high line. You know what I'm saying? That was a beautiful song.
In the post-production,
man. Huh?
We can add that song in on the post-production.
I could dig it, but I'm feeling like Big Red. Yeah. So that make you Bird. I'm feeling like Big Red. when are my office hours? Bird, this is not my office. Bird? Now Bird.
Oh, so Kwame, you asked about the movie thing, man. Let me tell y'all this. I'm kind of concerned that y'all, I bet none of y'all watched The Last Lioness. None of y'all watched The Last Lioness.
No.
Well,
I'm telling you, man.
Well, hold on. For your information, I watched it 2 weeks from now. Since you on your time traveling shit, and my 2 week limit.
That's why I called in about the time traveling stuff.
Huh? Oh.
So. Yesterday I was rapping with Mama Condi, right? And she mentioned something about astral projecting into the future. And I busted out laughing, right? And I couldn't stop laughing. So she started giggling and stuff. And so finally I was able to tell her, I said, Mama Condi, picture this. I said, imagine, you know, a brother, hungry as heck, you know, just got off work, hungry as heck. He got a nice, juicy pizza in front of him, right? And if he's a vegetarian, it's a vegetarian pizza, all right? So this brother get him a nice piece of pizza, man. He get ready to bite out of it. And a brother projects into the future. Matches his pizza. Goes back
home. Oh, hard. How far in the future did he go with the pizza?
So, you know, this was a hungry brother, you know. So basically the idea was this. You know, you have the homeless and those who are without food in the present. So what's going on is that you're projecting them far enough into the future where there's plenty of food so that they can snatch some food and bring it back, you know, to the past for those who are hungry.
Man,
but you know, the hunger situation ain't never been about, like time. It's been about faith.
About who?
About faith. What? Meaning that it's hungry people here, but it's people that's full, too. So it's not a scarcity of food. It's about where.
No, it ain't even a...
So yeah, you're correct in the sense, in one sense. But if we're able to quote unquote transport to the future,
yeah,
then we can transport to some wealthy people's homes. Get what we need.
But really, you know what's gonna happen with that, right? They had a movie about that. And you already know what's going to happen with that. That's when they form time police. And motherfucker, because that's the only way that they're going to form time police is when you start fucking with their money. And they're going to start noticing, well, hold on, the books ain't right. Even though it's projected in the, well, fuck, time police! You know what I'm saying? They're going to do something. They're going to come up with something to, you know. But the issue is...
called chrono cop.
You know what I'm saying? Because something going wrong before it's supposed to go wrong. But that's how creativity happened. And in a sense, it's good that we have these type of conversations. Because Steve Coakley, the last time he was here, and I keep on bringing this up, the last time he was here, Steve Coakley, somebody asked him, well, you tell us all this stuff, but you know what I'm saying? What is the future for black folks? And Steve Coakley turned around and asked her, he said, how many black futures writers do we have? Because in a sense, we create the future now in our writings. If we look at the cell phones that we have, although people say the technology was there, the inspiration for that technology came from young people like ourselves or that was a little bit older than us watching Star Trek saying, I want a phone like that. Yeah, I want a chick to be able to call me from Venus without any fees. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just like, you know, and we got to really understand that. So if we want to know the future of black folks, the question is, are we writing it? You know what I'm saying? Because the whole concept that you put down, and I was thinking about you today, Kwame, because I'm like, we got a math genius in our midst. We got a math teacher, not just 1+1, but somebody that can see the formulas dancing in their head that we don't have our kids surrounding. You understand what I'm saying? There should be a group of young people around you that need to be learning how to fall in love with math, because you don't just, it's a rare individual that could just be like, I'm going to fall in love with, you know, because, you know, math ain't sexy. She ain't sexy at first. You understand what I'm saying? You have to cultivate yourself. Yeah, after you get to know her. See, you get her with the clothes. The kids is getting her with the clothes on, you know, plus and minus. And they don't really see the connection between that and other than counting money. They don't get to see the sexy curves of mathematics. They don't get to see the protruding breast of mathematics. You know what I'm saying? They don't get that. They don't even get to ask
the question. The rear of the sphere. Did Diane leave this conversation?
Yeah, she left. She left.
Hey, listen. I gotta put this out here right now, man. Because, you know, my thing is about alignment. It's about alignment. It's about triangulation. It's about all these mathematical terms that we all have power to be able to utilize and to demonstrate. So this is what I'm going to say. We've been doing this movie thing, right? And that's beautiful. Man, look, I want to be able to break down short series. Like, this is a series that I've been watching. A series that actually is become on my top three of all time. All right? Now, I ain't going to bore y'all with Heroes. Because not that Heroes is boring at all. That's my favorite show in the whole world, number one. By the same,
you talking about the old one?
Creators.
You talking about the Heroes. Old Heroes? Okay.
Yeah. From 2000, I think it started in 2006 and went four seasons. Now, the same creator created a show called Touch. And Touch only lasted two seasons. Heroes only lasted four seasons. They were both interrupted by the writer's strike. The fourth season of Heroes was actually written by the actors, because they didn't have writers, right? Because of the writer's strike. But Touch is one of the most phenomenal shows when it comes to math, when it comes to, you know, breaking down the Fibonacci sequence in terms of sacred mathematics sacred geometry. All right, without saying, the phenomenon that it is,
right,
in terms of what it represents.
They just on a higher, they show
They get you, man, I'm just saying.
They get you behind. They get you behind the scenes so you can do the peep show and be like, "Ooh, I'm in love with her." And before you know it, you're in love with man. Call in number is, I'm driving. Hold on, 614-556-4535. Once again, that's 614-556-4535. Once again, that's 614-556-4535. Somebody on the Giami timeline is asking for the number. But now, Kashaka, now what you're bringing up is... It is an avenue that we need to hit, because when I say Giami Journey Media, I'm not playing, because the whole piece that I'm saying is we need to be breaking down those shows. We need to have those conversations about shows so that our people know what to put their time into. You understand what I'm saying? Because you got all these shows. Yeah. Now we should be having a
listen. I'm gonna ask y'all Giami right now, like. If we set out to watch just a pilot from Touch, how long till we can have a conversation about it? Because I'm anxious.
Wait, time out.
I'm itching.
Shaka, this is where you get it mixed up. We all don't have to watch it. See, because how can I put it? Where are our critics for our community? This is a must see. I mean, you turn on the radio, motherfuckers say, "This is a must-see." And then they'll go and break down the story. And then our job is to intrigue people to be able to watch these so that we can develop the conversation that we need to have from it. Because I hear you. Because we probably could watch Touch and do it. But we have a platform, Shaka, see, because we don't need to get caught up in numbers. What we need to get caught up in is delivering the content. So... maybe you might have to write a song about Touch, or we got somebody with those writer skills that can sit up there and watch Touch and tell our folk on our timelines why they need to watch it, right? So that we can have a show. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? Because right now on YouTube, there are young people right now making like hundreds of thousands of dollars. Basically,
you know, you're right, man.
Breaking down comic books, breaking down TV shows. It ain't shit for us to do it. I mean, Shaka, because think about it. We sit down and talk off the cuff for hours. Off the cuff. This is without a fucking script.
Right.
So, when I say Giami Journey Media, that's what I'm talking about. Whoever was out there, the number.
Okay.
Hold on. Oh. I'm sorry, my slow ass, you wanted me to post the number up. I got it. I'm sorry, because you're driving. I understand. Don't hang up. There must be Navita. You should have this number locked in. 614, but go ahead, Shaka. You was about to say something.
No, you know what? I guess you put that into perspective. You're right. You know, so I'm gonna put this little thing together. You know, that's the thing for me, is that post production will take forever. Like, I got all these ideas, and I know what my weakness is. This is post production, meaning like I got this idea right now about the Touch and want to share it with y'all, and I'm like, ooh, and then I can just put like something on YouTube now, show the pictures of the characters and things. Like, I mean, because we got the tools, man. Sit down and actually do it. I got stuff from January
Just do it. Because this is the issue.
Yeah, you're right.
Because what happened is, we'll get the young people that we need to do it, or we'll get the older people that we need that will be able to come in afterwards and fix it up. You know what I'm saying? It's just a matter of us doing it. 614-556, because my Hootsuite is not working. And see, and listen, I got Hootsuite, but this whole scandal with Russia is killing all of these type of programs like this right here. So I need to let y'all know. I might have to be getting rid of my Hootsuite. And I'm holding on to Uber
Car. What is a
Hootsuite? Hootsuite is a program that allows me I could throw up my Facebook page, my Facebook individual page, my Facebook Giami Journey page, my Twitter page, my YouTube video page, my Instagram page, all on one screen. And I'll be able to see what's going on on all of them at the exact same time and post to them as rapidly as possible. So.
Okay.
So, you know, and like I said, I've been, see, and what people don't understand is, like, I'm not good at this technology, but I'm good at catching those shit like that. And I'll be trying to bring, I'll be bringing my people in. I'll be like, yo, hey, I need some help learning how to work with this. Nah, I ain't got time for that. You know what I'm saying? But they always on Facebook. How do, you know what I'm saying? How you don't have time for something that's going to make you better on Facebook when there's people, when we know there's people that's getting paid that know how to use Facebook? I'm trying to give you a tool so that you can become a master. Once you become a master, then people are going to start seeking your services. When they start seeking your services, then you start getting paid. And once you start getting paid, that's when the shakedown coming, because Giami is going to be knocking at your door. Y'all just fucking with me.
What's the next? What's the next movie we watch, yo?
Nah, that's the question.
Park yet?
No, we right now. I'm waiting for the votes to come in, but I can read the list to you if that's what you want.
Yeah.
All right, let's do that. Hold on, give me a second. Give me a second. Let me pin this number up. Cause you in the car.
How are we supposed to post our vote?
I basically sent out a Google form, and like I said, you just click the form and go down the list and you'll be able to get it. And then, like I said, I could either submit your vote, or your wife could submit your vote, or
go ahead and submit my vote. It's Kitty
Coop. But how you know I didn't already submit it? Because I already knew what you wanted anyway. But actually, I'm with you on that, because Kiraku covers so much and is a folktale. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, we're going to let the people decide, but then we can keep Kiraku on the list. But then an idea came to me. Somebody else is on the line. We want to welcome you. An idea came to me where I was thinking, I said, I got a documentary too. So I'm gonna put my documentary on the next list. I ain't gonna put it on this list. I'm putting the Underground Railroad documentary on there. And then also, this is the next step. Like Shaka, what I'm telling you, right? I'm going to inspire our young people to do a documentary on No More X. And the Afro set. Because I'm sick of, like, Black Panthers, they get props, right? But, you know, we come from, our consciousness here in Columbus and Cleveland, in Northeast and Central Ohio, come from a group called the Afro set that you rarely ever hear anything about.
Right.
Yeah, I need y'all to understand that. The consciousness here in Ohio come from a group called the Afro set. You know what I'm saying? That at the same time when the Black Panthers was blowing up, the Afro set was holding it down here. As a matter of fact, the Afro set took over the police station in Cleveland. That's written out of history. The Afro set used to patrol down here in Columbus and used to chase the pimps up out the community. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, I'm just saying, so some of our young people is going to go and get those FBI files, because really, if you want to paint the story, all you got to do is go and get those files. But the reason, and I want you to understand this, the reason that nobody really is hyping them up and people want these type of histories to be forgotten is very simple. Because of who we're going to find out was not really down with the movement. Because all of a sudden has become down with the movement. So I'm just throwing that out there. So I'm telling you, Shaka, I'm gonna do something sloppy at first, and then, cause you know, it's sort of like when you're a kid and you know your parents gonna help you with something, and you just go out, you do the little sloppy shit, and then your parent come in and be like, man, give me, let me fix this up for you. Nah, I want to do it on my own. Right. You know what I'm saying? You get to get it. All right, so let me read the movie list. Right now, on our list, we have The Wiz, we have Cooley High, Claudine, A Great and Mighty Walk. That's a documentary about
Dr. John Henry Clark.
We got Hidden Colors, the first one. Dead Presidents, Cornbread, Earl and Me, White Man's Burden, Mo' Better Blues. I make my living with my lips. Straight Outta Compton, Thin Line Between Love and Hate, and Boomerang.
No.
Ain't nobody gonna, because Boomerang and Thin Line Between Love and Hate is the same damn movie anyway. But anyway, Sankofa.
Kirikou. You gotta remember, if there's a negative image being put forth, then we need to point that out, because somebody else in our community may be looking at that as something to follow. So if we just put,
get on,
that's right, watch movies that just have a positive image, we also need to watch movies that some have negative images. We need to break it down to why this is problematic.
Wait a minute, sister, you sound a lot like Navita. We got a sister in the community. Is this Navita? No, this can't be.
I know it is.
This can't be Navita asking for the call in line number. I know this is not Navita asking for the. This is not Navita.
No, time out though, because you know what? She's got a point there. Because,
oh, she definitely got a point. But I just want to know who it is, because she sounds like Navita.
Look.
It is me.
So what you calling in asking for the number for?
We're not missing the point, but a lot of the movie, well, anyway, the last two movies we've seen bordered on, you know, for the most part, adult content. And I think using this notion of Kirikou, it's one of those things that touches at all levels, like a good folktale should, or a good fable should. And so that's why I'm pushing toward Kirikou, because I want to grab some kids and bring them in. But anyway, this is a group thing. Made the best movie. Or at least the
most
would be
winning. Hey, now I'm saying, I haven't limited the votes either. So you don't have to vote one time. Hey, go ahead.
Now, one of my favorite movies, of course, off of the list is Mo' Better Blues. But I don't think that as a group we're going to have a conversation that I really want to pull out of that. Because, see, Denzel's role, as Ms. Navita said, it can go one of two ways. And for me, I've experienced both sides of the coin, being a musician, being an artist first, and where everything else is kind of secondary to that. Everything else kind of got to mold into that world of my creations. And that's what he was dealing with in the movie, is being a band leader and being devoted to his craft and having these two sisters in his life, right? So, with that setup,
I'm telling on yourself, brother.
It can be identified as, you know, a man who was obsessed with his music, and who, in that sense, had a very derogatory role or position in these sisters' lives. You know, being a player, right? And for me, I don't necessarily see it that way. You know, both of those sisters, in the sense, they kind of fulfilled two different purposes. One of them said that the higher self, and the other felt the lower. But the piece is that because they had sexual relationships, a lot of people don't see the difference.
All right.
You know, what I'm saying is that, go ahead.
Shaka, you know what they call this, right?
What?
Dry snitching. Brother, I'm trying to shut up. Just stop. All right?
You know what? Not the dry snitch.
You just telling all on yourself. I'm just like your brother. You know, the two sisters, they're not really. Listen, man. You got that pretty olive oil voice. You just move into people's lives and it's just ruin them. And then you break them down to songs. Look, girl, I'm going to break up with you. I'm going to leave you a song. Here you go.
Look, bro. Hey, Shaka. Yeah, Shaka. When I was at Oberlin College, you know they have a conservatory there, right?
Right.
And,
beautiful conservatory.
So, right. And so a lot of the brothers, we'd have these talent nights, right? And, you know, impromptu and everything. And so, you know, we just set up some chairs, you know, in the lounges, and we had pianos in the lounges and stuff. And so we get sisters get up and sing. And then these brothers out of the damn conservatory. These Negroes get on the piano and say, this is for that special moment out there. You know who you are. And they start now, you know, in a small college where, of course, this is being done in the African Heritage House, so everybody know everybody's business. And everybody know that brother sleeping with three women on this side of campus, and then another three on the other side of campus.
Wow.
And many of them will be in the crowd thinking, well, swooning over those ambiguous words.
He's singing about me. All right, family, listen.
I'm saying if we do anything that's relationship related,
we're going to definitely have to do something.
Expand upon that.
Yes, we
and
can.
And now, I don't know what the Syracuse is about. That's my first time hearing
it. It's about it. Well, hold on.
I don't mind
Let me
watching
tell you.
It.
It's about
as long as we can get other people that don't mind watching it.
It's about a baby player.
What?
Hey, listen. Listen. It's about a baby player. Listen, this won't even ruin the mood. Kiriku decided when he was going to be born, where he was going to be born, how he was going to be born, and he decided on who he liked. So, I mean, it's a deep
look,
move.
Look, the brother's first words was, "Mother, bring me into the world."
Okay.
A young player. That's what I'm just saying. Listen. You have to see Kiriku now. That's but it's based on the vote. But family, unfortunately, I gotta go because it's Cleveland's celebration. We about to go on and do that, and I haven't cleaned the car out yet. And you know how that go. So I'm got to go clean out the car.
Yeah.
So, but I want to thank everybody for taking the time.
Clean out the car.
And I'm saying peace. Oh, and this Allende calling me now. Let me go. Because I've been trying to reach him.
One love,
family. Peace out,
peace.
Facebook.
Peace.
Allende, what's going on? Hold on. Hey, Allende.